Resident Evil 4 is coming to the Oculus Quest, and I could not be more excited about it. Even though I don't really like Resident Evil. I'll explain, it makes sense, don't worry. A few days ago, Facebook held its Oculus Showcase event where we got a glimpse of what's coming to the system in the next couple of months. There's a lot of interesting titles, some DLC to existing content. Most of it wasn't exactly new. I imagine that since Facebook is new to the whole gaming scene, they don't run as tight a ship as, say, Nintendo, and a lot of that stuff had already leaked in the community. So we knew, like, most of the things that we saw were not exactly a surprise, including Resident Evil 4, which in my opinion was the big standout of the event. Now, like I said in the very beginning, I personally never cared for Resident Evil. Not even Resident Evil 7, which has a VR mode. So that should tell you right there that I'm not the greatest Resident Evil fanboy. And it's a pretty safe assumption that if you care about this game, you probably already own it multiple times over, because Resident Evil 4 is one of the most ported over games ever. It came out for everything. It came out on cell phones back in 2009, when the mobile gaming scene was nowhere near what we have today. In fact, I think this thing is probably the last system that Resident Evil 4 was not available for. So if you cared about Resident Evil 4, you have probably beat it several times on several different systems. And if you don't care about Resident Evil 4, which is my case, well, then you shouldn't be excited for this release, right? In theory, yes, but as a VR enthusiast, I'm extremely excited to have a title like Resident Evil 4 coming to the system. Resident Evil 4, which came out in 2005, was groundbreaking both for the franchise itself and for gaming in general. So many games that came out after Resident Evil 4 were influenced by it. It's hard to overstate how significant a release that game was. So with that come a lot of things. One way the Oculus Quest 2 is going to massively benefit from this release, and I say Oculus Quest 2 because this is going to be the first title that is exclusive to the Oculus Quest 2. Oculus One owners, unfortunately, will have to upgrade to the new model if they intend to play this game. And it's a bummer. A lot of people are understandably upset, but that's them breaks. So when you're talking about the cutting edge, at some point, legacy hardware just is not going to be supported anymore. On the positive side, these things retain their value really well. The Oculus Quest 2 is not that expensive when you consider how much it cost to get into VR 5 or 6 years ago, so there's that. Going back to what I was talking about, one of the big benefits of having this game come out for the Oculus Quest 2 is brand recognition. I think one of the main challenges VR enthusiasts like myself have is when we try to introduce this to people, they are typically not going to be able to play the games that they associate with gaming. You're not gonna have your God of War, you're not gonna have your Call of Duty, you're not gonna have the big AAA titles that everybody knows and loves. In a lot of ways, VR, being in its infancy, is seen more like a toy, like a distraction. There are amazing experiences in VR, but most of them are new titles made by indie developers that most people never heard of. My absolute favorite VR experiences are games that the, let's call it, the mainstream gaming audiences never even heard of. So to be able to bring this to a friend's house and say, oh, by the way, you can play Resident Evil 4 on this thing. Yeah, it's a game from 2005, but it's Resident Evil 4. It's a lot easier to get somebody excited about this technology if you say you can play Resident Evil 4 than if you were to say, oh, you can play Swarm on it. It's my favorite game at the moment. Nobody knows what it is. My experience with Resident Evil 4 was watching my brother beat it several times over back in our PS2. So to me, it's going, because I'm buying this day one. This is gonna be my first Resident Evil, by the way. So I'm getting started in the franchise with Resident Evil 4 in virtual reality. So I'm very excited. I'm almost glad that I slept on this series as long as I have, because there's not going to be a better way to, I mean, provided they don't botch the port completely, fingers crossed. Assuming they don't do that, it's going to be the best way to experience this game, right? Even if you are a seasoned Resident Evil 4 veteran, to be in the game and to handle the guns with your own hands and to be able to look around and feel the sense of anxiety when zombies start shuffling towards you, it's gonna be something else. Like, you think you know immersive entertainment until you play a virtual reality game. So on top of that, this makes me wonder, what if other titles from previous generations make the jump to virtual reality, with of course improved user interfaces and textures, and because this is a remaster, make no mistake, it's not gonna be the exact same game you played on the GameCube, it's gonna be improved for the new hardware. So that alone, I mean, not for people who have played it, say, on the PS4, but for me, my recollections of Resident Evil 4 are PS2 graphics, so now it's gonna look better. So it got me thinking, what if more developers brought their older titles to virtual reality? What if we had, say, Star Wars Battlefront 2? Yes, the same 2005 release, same year as Resident Evil 4, mind you. What if they decide to port that over to virtual reality? What if I can fly? What if I can shoot stormtroopers in the face, then run to an X-Wing and take off and then shoot them in the face, but now from the air? Like, my God, if they port Star Wars Battlefront 2 for the Oculus Quest, I'm telling you right now, this channel will likely die because you will not be able to take this thing from my face. Oh, I love that game so much. I'm so excited for this. This is the kind of thing that virtual reality needed to make that extra push. Facebook, love them or hate them, and I know a lot of you hate them, they did a lot to popularize virtual reality. As somebody who grew up obsessed with this technology back when it was like a sci-fi thing, to have it now is magical to me. And to have companies bringing these massive, huge titles that will likely make virtual reality even more popular, I'm very excited, even if it's an older game. In fact, especially because it's an older game. Because think of that incredibly huge catalog of PS2, PS3 titles that would be amazing to play in virtual reality. And that's where I want to end this video on. What game would you drop serious, serious money on if it was available in virtual reality? Because I'm telling you right now, I would pay upwards of $100 sight unseen before the reviews were even out. If they announce that Electronic Arts for once is going to do the right thing and they're going to port Star Wars Battlefront 2, the 2005 PS2 version, for the Oculus Quest, my God. And that's just one game. So let me know in the comments what older title you would love to experience again, but this time in virtual reality. The conversation doesn't have to be limited to the comments here. You can follow me on social media, both Twitter and Instagram. I'm very active on both. And on Instagram, I show a lot of behind the scenes stuff, how the sausage gets made, if you will. If you're into that sort of technical stuff, you're gonna like my Instagram. Follow me there. But that's all the time I have for today. I'm Izzy and I'm done.